Concierge medicine, when it first originated, was kind of based on the notion that physicians would charge an annual or monthly fee to patients. And then in return, the patients would receive unparalleled care, which included, you know, same day appointments, house calls, and then these remote services, email, phone correspondence. And then the purpose of having this is to kind of decrease the patient load for the physician and allow more time to be spent with individual patients on a day-to-day basis. Mm-hmm. Now, concierge medicine in general has grown and expanded into different branches like direct primary care and different hybrid systems. And then on top of that, physicians like myself kind of pick and choose from different aspects of it to create our own little niche and our own little, like, quote unquote, concierge practice.
Okay.
So for example, unlike concierge, like primary doctors that charge an annual or monthly fee, I'm still on a fee for service schedule. So I don't accept insurance, I'm cash pay. But for the reason I don't charge an annual fee or a monthly fee is because I'm not seeing those chronic issues or having patients follow up on a very routine basis like the primary care doctors do.
Okay.
At the same time, I limit my patient load. Each patient gets about an hour with me each visit instead of, you know, 15, 20 minutes. And then after becoming a patient of mine, I also don't charge for email or phone correspondence. So they've got free remote access to me afterwards. I can see them again, you know, same day, after hours, on the weekends, you know, during the holidays, in office, at home. You know, I kind of make myself available to them. And the purpose is to create more of like an intimate relationship with the patients and allowing them to be able to be seen when and where they want to. So that's why I consider myself in like the concierge medicine route, even though I may not have all those little aspects of what you consider concierge practice.
Okay.